Senator Cameron. Senator Paterson.
Thank you, Mr. President. My question is to the Minister representing the Treasurer, Senator Cormann. Can the Minister update the Senate on the performance of Australia's economy under the Coalition government?
Order. I will again, before I call Senator Cormann, ask for silence during questions so that I may hear them. Senator Cormann.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. After 5 years of coalition government, the economy is in much better shape than when we found it. More jobs are being created and the budget is in a stronger position. It should never be forgotten. It should never be forgotten that the Labor Party, in which Mr. Bowen was the Treasurer and Mr. Shorten was a senior minister in the education and employment portfolio, the Labor Party, when they lost government in September 2013, left behind a weakening economy, rising unemployment and a rapidly deteriorating budget position. Today the economy is growing more strongly, the economic growth outlook is much better, employment growth is much stronger than what it was, the unemployment rate is well below it was where it was headed, and indeed the budget position is in much better shape on a much stronger foundation and trajectory for the future. The national accounts for the June 2018 quarter showed 3.4% growth in through the year terms, stronger than any G7 economy and stronger than the OECD. In year average terms, which is what we publish in the budget, our economy grew by 2.9%, above our forecast of 2.75% published in the 2018-19 budget. Nominal GDP grew by 4.7% on a year average basis, also above the budget forecast of 4.25%. In the period since we were elected to government in September 2013, more than 1 million new jobs were created in the Australian economy. When Tony Abbott went to the 2013 election promising more than 1 million new jobs in 5 years, the Labor Party sneered at us. They said it couldn't be done. Well, over 5 years of Abbott and Turnbull-led coalition governments, we have delivered, and of course the Scott Morrison government, the Morrison government in strong coalition with Deputy Prime Minister McCormack, we will continue to build on the achievements of the past 5 years. But of course the Labor Party still hasn't
Order,
learned any
Senator
of the
Cormann,
lessons
Senator Cormann, time
of the
for
past.
The answer has expired. Order on my left. Senator Paterson, a supplementary question.
Thank you, Mr. President. How is the coalition government ensuring that the economy continues to grow to create more jobs and guarantee essential services?
Senator Cormann.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. We will continue to pursue a pro-business, pro-jobs, pro-opportunity agenda where all Australians have the best possible opportunity to get ahead. On this side of the chamber, we understand that to create more jobs, we need to provide the environment for business to be more successful into the future, which is, of course, why we have worked so hard to create a more growth-friendly business tax system. That's why we have worked so hard as part of our ambitious free trade agenda to create better opportunities for Australian exporting businesses to sell Australian products and services around the world. That is why we've worked so hard implementing our ambitious productivity-enhancing infrastructure investment program. And that is why, in coming weeks and months, we will continue to work hard to bring electricity prices down. Under Labor, electricity prices would go up and up. Under the coalition, electricity prices will continue to go down, because that is good for households and that is good for business around Australia.
Senator, order on my left during the question being asked. Senator Paterson, final supplementary question.
Thank you, Mr. President. What are the risks to ongoing job creation, economic growth and putting the budget on a stronger foundation and trajectory for the future?
Senator Cormann.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. The biggest risk to our economic opportunity into the future would be a return to the discredited policies of the past from the Labor Party. Because, of course, Bill Shorten and Chris Bowen were there at the scene of the weakening economy, rising unemployment and a rapidly deteriorating budget position. They were senior ministers in a government that left Australian families worse off on the back of lower growth, weakening rising unemployment and, indeed, a rapidly deteriorating budget position. Labor hasn't learned any of the lessons. They are going forward again with the same discredited anti-business, anti-opportunity, higher taxes agenda, which would hurt the economy, hurt families and cost jobs. When they last were in government, they wanted to push up taxes on everything and everyone that moves. They are at it again. More than $200 billion worth of tax increases already on the table, targeting families, targeting business, targeting investors, targeting seniors. everyone and anyone in Australia.
Order, Senator Cormann. Time for the answer has expired. Senator